October 8, 2012. Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Allen.
Here.
Dixon. Gibbons.
Here.
Hannon.
Present.
Harrison.
Present.
McLean.
Here.
Mowry.
Here.
O'Brien.
Present.
Hey, seven present.
We have seven members present at this time for the flag, the Pledge of Allegiance. We have Boy Scout Troop Number 215, the Hawk Patrol, will be performing the ceremony for tonight's council meeting.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Harrison.
Can I ask the adult 215 if the distribution of the other thoughts starts? If he's conjuring in your troops that's distributing the yellow dot.
Sir. He's not here.
He is in our troops.
Yeah, that, you don't know whether the distribution has started yet or not? I'll call. I intended to call today and I just forgot. When he starts distributing it, I want to make people, you know, the scouts spoke to it last month, but I just want to make sure that people know that if you see my car, you'll see the yellow dots on there already.
Thank you very much. Okay, at this time, I'd like to turn to chair announcements. There was an executive session of council conducted tonight before we came out, October 8, 2012, police, EMS, and personnel issues. This time, I'd like to turn to the reports of the officials in the librarian's report.
Good evening. My name is Christine. I'm the director of your public library, where we provide services to inform, inspire, and enrich the community. One happy thing to report is that one of our fish had babies. So, yes, we are going in the right direction. Now I need a bigger tank. just a few programs to report, to talk about. It is October, so we do a lot of Halloween programming. And there is a program for children on Saturday, October 27th, I want to say it is, at 7 o'clock after the library closes. It's a lot of fun. So it's for kindergarten through fifth grade, and you do need to register. Also, we have Haunted Pittsburgh is coming on Tuesday, October 16th at 7 o'clock. It will be here in Council Chambers. They will be doing a Pittsburgh virtual ghost tour. So it's a slideshow of prominent Pittsburgh places with accompanying stories about ghosts in the area. Also on Friday, October 19th at 11 a.m., we are having our annual Haunted Hat Tea. We have ladies, we haven't had any men ever come, but the ladies come and we do a contest who has the most unique Halloween hat. Some of them are witches' hats, some of them are themed. They have spider webs and bats and some sort. So it's a lot of fun. And also, I just wanted to highlight, since school is back in session, a lot of students are preparing for taking the SAT or the PSAT. We do have a database called the Testing and Educational Resource Center. All you need is a library card to access it. And you can take full-length practice tests, not only of the SAT or the PSAT, but also the practice exams for teachers, civil service exams, firefighter, EMS, nursing, any test that you can think of, you can take a full practice test free of charge. And two fundraising items. This Saturday, October 13th, is our fourth annual Fall Craft and Vendor Fair, which will be held at the community center. We have outgrown the space here. And on Tuesday, October 16th, we're having our TGI Fridays fundraiser from 5 to 8 p.m. You can get a coupon either. You got one through email. If you have a library card and an email address, you're on our list. Or you can pick one up at the library. If you hand that to your wait staff, The library will receive 20% of your total check for that evening. And the proceeds of all of our fundraising activities support the programs and services of the library. If you want any more information on these or the many other programs and services we offer, you can check our website at bethelparklibrary.org. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This time we turn to the police chief's report and Chief Mackey.
Thank you, Mr. Mowry. Good evening, everyone. I actually have several items this evening and hope you'll bear with me. I'll try to get through them quickly. First thing I wanted to mention tonight was last week the municipality hosted a retirement luncheon for a very special lady. Her name is Josie Staffen. And Josie was the secretary in the police department, and she was an employee of the municipality for 25 years. Not quite sure how many of those years were with the police department. Most of them were, because for the last 13 years, she was the secretary to the chief of police. And Josie usually watches the meetings. I hope she's watching tonight, because one more time, I just publicly wanted to thank her for her terrific service. Not only to the police department, but to the community for the last 25 years. She's just a wonderful, wonderful lady, and we all wish her the best in her retirement.
Chief, can I say a few?
Absolutely.
Josie was our good news, bad news person, but she handled it with such professionalism. You'd get a call, and she'd either tell you some wonderful things that happened, or she would tell you things that weren't quite right, but she always did it in such a great way. And when you call in here to get the chief, she was always the buffer before the chief, and she would say, police department. She always put you in a good mood. Maybe you didn't have such good news to discuss with the chief. But she's my neighbor also, and she's been great, and that's a lot of years of service, and she will be missed. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. O'Brien. Next item. We, the police department, received quite a surprise last month in the mail. I got a letter along with a check for $620, and the check was designated for the Charles Bonzak Scholarship Fund. This check came from the Bethel Park High School Class of 1962, the 50th Reunion Committee. As it turns out, one of the gentlemen from that class was Charles Bonzak's brother. And Charles, of course, was a sergeant, served 40 years on the police department. And after Charles' passing a few years ago, we started the scholarship fund. As you may or may not be aware, every year we do a law enforcement apprenticeship program for high school students here in Bethel Park. And these are kids that are interested in careers in law enforcement. And at the end of the year, we offer scholarships to those students as they move on to college because they're going to be studying law enforcement or criminal justice. So needless to say, it was quite a surprise, and very thankful that we received this check. And I wanted to thank the reunion committee, the 50th year reunion committee, for their very generous donation. And I received the letter from Noreen Motory, class treasurer. Noreen Mercer Motory, class treasurer. So once again, 50th Reunion Committee, thank you very much. One of my officers approached me the other day. He got involved in a project. There is going to be a special movie screening. It's a movie called Heroes Behind the Badge. And it's a documentary film that they're actually going to preview at the Bethel Park High School Auditorium. This is going to be on November 17th at 7 p.m. The executive producer of the film, Lieutenant William Airfirth, who is retired, he's going to be there for questions and answers. They're going to have a screening of the film Heroes Behind the Badge. They're also going to have a performance by the Greater Pittsburgh Police Pipes and Drums Band. Tickets are $15 in advance or $20 at the door, and we will have those tickets available at the police records room if you are interested. Once again, Saturday, November 17th at 7 p.m. Our next Crime Watch meeting will be October 11th, 6:30, Bethel Park Community Center, as usual. And we have a special guest, Secret Service Agent Christopher Watson, and he's going to be talking about counterfeiting and credit card fraud, which is credit card fraud is one of those particular problems that the police department deals a lot with lately. So you don't have to be a member to come and enjoy this presentation. I think you can learn an awful lot about how to protect yourself and your identity. I mentioned last month, I believe, that the police department received a donation from the Bethel Community Foundation for a new child identification system. We've been using that system. We have three schools completed. That's Ben Franklin, Memorial, and Neil Armstrong. Over 1,050 child identification cards have been distributed already, and we have a couple more schools to go. So this is a terrific program. If you have children in elementary or kindergarten, you'll receive a notice. And of course, this is completely voluntary. We will produce the identification card and turn it over to the parents. Police department does not maintain that information. The next Citizens Police Academy starts on Wednesday, January 16th. It's a 12-week program. We have applications available with the police department, or you can contact Officer Rigatti. That would be trigatti@bethelparkpolice.net. Shoot him an email, and he'll make sure you get an application. We conducted a drug take-back program a couple weeks ago. And I've said it before, this is such a hugely successful program. And once again, we took in over 90 pounds of unused, unwanted, expired medication. And this is all in pill form. So you can imagine, pills don't weigh very much, and we took in 90 pounds. And this is the same story every time we do the program. Extremely, extremely successful. And the next time the Drug Enforcement Administration notifies us for another take back, of course, we will participate, and we typically have two locations. We utilize the community center and the Highmark Direct building up at Norman Center. The Bethel Park Police Pal Food Drive will start on Monday, November 26th, and it will run until Wednesday, December 19th. So there'll be more information to come on that, looking obviously for non-perishable food items and monetary donations to help out the less fortunate during the holidays. Halloween. As every other year, we celebrate Halloween on Halloween. And this year it's Wednesday, October 31st from 6 p.m. till 8 p.m. When the officers go into the elementary schools and talk to the kids about Halloween safety, we tell them only to go to the houses with porch lights on. So if you're going to participate in Halloween at your residence, please turn your porch lights on. That way the children will be directed to your house. If you don't have a light, we always tell the children not to go to those houses. And also, please be aware that there's a lot of people out, not only children, but adults. And please drive carefully, and we ask the parents to bring along some flashlights to warn the motorist. I think that's enough.
Wow.
That was probably the biggest one ever. Any questions?
Any questions?
Hearing none, thank you very much, Chief Mackey. We turn to the fire chief's report.
Okay, good evening, everybody. I'm just going to go over quickly the reports of last month, the month of September, of the fire calls. Last month we had two building fires, one vehicle fire, one vehicle accident with extrication, one gas leak, one power line down, one arcing and short electrical equipment on a power pole, one building partially collapsed, one smoke scare inside of a building. We had six smoke detector activations due to a malfunction, six alarm system malfunctions, four CO detector malfunctions, and one alarm system activation that was unintentional. So that was a total of 26 calls for the month of September. I also have a couple things I wanted to go over over latest events. Yesterday, if you drove down Brentwood Road, you would have seen all of our trucks set up. We had our annual open house. We wanted to thank everybody for coming out to that and supporting us. Special thanks goes out to EV Hardware and Bethel Bakery, who also helped participate in this event. I believe Bethel Bakery had a lot of stuff set up, giving away some things. So it was a great event for everybody that came out. A couple weeks ago, we had a couple events going on for fundraising. We had a fundraiser on a Friday night at down at Barley's and Hops. We were selling food and had raffles going on. So thanks to everybody that came out to that. And the day after that, or 2 days after that, I believe, actually, on Sunday, we did a Fill the Boot. If you don't, not sure what that is, we go out to the park intersection down at Corrigan Drive. And this time, we also went up to the intersection at Oxford and Fort Couch. And we walked up and down the intersection with boots out, collecting money. And so a lot of people dumped their change in. We're more than happy to carry around for you. So thank you very much. This month, October, change your batteries in your smoke detectors. Also, clocks go back, kind of going hand in hand there. Also want to point out, your smoke detectors have a lifetime of about 10 years. You know, a lot of people don't realize how long that smoke detector has been hanging on the wall. If you look at the bottom, you know, as a data manufacturer, if you're still unsure, you really don't know when it was changed, change the smoke detectors out. They're only good for 10 years. It's not going to beep like your low battery alarm, okay? It's just not going to perform as well. The same thing goes for CO detectors. They have a lifetime of only 5 years, so make sure you change those out as well after 5 years. Next up, space heaters. It's getting cold outside. Make sure you don't use them 24/7 to heat your house. They're meant to be used in a small room, you know, in your basement. You're just trying to heat the room a little extra when you're in there. So make sure you follow the manufacturer's recommendations on that and you have proper space around it. We have quite a few fires every year due to space heaters. Trick-or-treat, this is a couple people have already brought up. We will be out on Halloween night. We'll be passing out candy, trying to get people to slow down, walking around kids. So if you see the fire truck, you know, wait till we stop. We will stop. We're not throwing candy out of the truck. We'll stop at intersections, you know, and hang out for a little bit, try to slow traffic down, pass some candy out. And lastly, we're on Facebook now. So you can like us on Facebook. Look up Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company. And you'll find us on there. Look for great safety tips and other events that are going on. So, any comments? Questions?
Mr. Harrison.
I'd like to do my monthly duty here and remind people that the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company relies on contributions. So you're encouraged to make your contributions. The tri-community actually works on subscriptions, but they're always willing to take contributions also. And the next comment I'm going to make, I didn't even talk to the fire company about it, it's just an idea, but lots of people in the Bethel Park area do not make contributions for whatever reason. And so I just got thinking, we don't want to discourage the people that make the contribution to the extent they feel they can. But if you had to be a family that's not making contributions, I'd like to suggest that there's no minimum amount. So you don't have to be embarrassed. For instance, because there's about 33,000 people in Bethel Park, if every one of those people, a family made a contribution based on the number of people in the household, that'd be $33,000. If they said, well, I can afford $3 per member of the household, that'd be $100,000. So I'm just, what I want to suggest that if you're sort of strapped, that you could even afford $1 or $2 or $5, don't be embarrassed. Send it in. It'll be helpful. And the thing I always remind people is that if the volunteer fire company cannot operate on contributions, we as a community are not going to like the cost it's going to impose on the community in terms of taxes. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah, every dollar counts. If you can only have a dollar in cash or a couple pennies you want to donate to us, feel free to stop down. We have a big fire hydrant sitting right inside of our door on Monday nights. The door's open. We're there from about 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock. Just stop by, throw in whatever pennies or change you have. Everything helps. So thank you.
Thank you very much. At this time, can we turn to the mayor's report? Mayor Morton.
Good evening, everyone. We're running a little bit late here tonight, but we'll get through it here quickly. Last Friday at noon, we had our 90-plus luncheon. 90-plus people years old, had 84 people out. And I want to thank our manager for coming down, Bill Spagnuolo, and saying a few words. Thank you, Bill. I want to thank, next to him, Jack Allen for donating ice cream sundaes for all the folks at the luncheon. And I want to thank John Welsh from Bethel Bakery for always, like Bethel Bakery does, they're always willing to help out wherever they can. So great, great luncheon we had, and people, many of them were their first time. Our only bad thing about this, you know, they start when they're 90 to belong to our club. We have identified over 100 people who are in that category. And the oldest one we had the other day was 104. And this man has been to all 8 of our luncheons that we've had. And he walks in just like we do, nothing to it. It's wonderful. So anyway, excuse me. So anyway, this month, I'll read your birthdays quickly. We wish happy birthday to Genevieve DeLugas, who is 91. Ella Moore, who turned to 92, as did Veronica Winkowski. Ruth Bachman and Josephine Spala are 93 this month. Katie Bradford is 94, and Stella Liss is 96. And happy birthday to all those, I guess they're all those ladies. That's right. This is a month when we just have ladies. So, happy birthday, 90-plus members. Now, I want to thank the Scouts for coming out again tonight. It's always good to have you guys here. Don't stop coming just because everybody's been here once. Come back again. We have a group of girls with us tonight, middle school girls down here in the red shirts. I'm going to ask them to come up, and they are doing a project called Bring a Smile to the Service. And I think when you hear their program, they'll bring a smile to you. So if you girls would come up, we have Macy Hall, Maria Jay, Natalie LaLama, Emma Harris, and Grace Brugman. Right? Come on up. Who's your spokesperson? All right, we're all going to do that. Whoever is talking, would you hold the mic and speak into it? Who's first? Okay.
Hi, everyone. That's Grace Brigman. Emma Harris, she's a 7th grader at Independence Middle School. Maria Jay, who's an 8th grader at Independence Middle School. Natalie LaLama, and I'm Macy Hall. And the three of us are freshmen at Bethel Park High School. We previously put together a presentation called Bring a Smile to a Soldier, but changed it to Bring a Smile to the Service because the Marines do not like to be called soldiers.
Did the mayor tell you that?
Okay, a little bit about us. Macy, Grace, and I were recruited by Mrs. Makel, and she teaches at Independence Middle School. She's a 7th grade social studies teacher, and we were recruited by her in 7th grade. And we went up during our lunch period every day to write to soldiers and Marines. We emailed servicemen and women, and we sent letters weekly and care packages monthly. And we communicated actually with not only the servicemen and women, but also with their families. And we sent gifts for holidays and their birthdays. We met over the summer to write, and this is probably the accomplishment that makes us all the most happy. We wrote and sent care packages to over 100 soldiers and Marines so far, still counting.
What we have done in the past. Over the years, we have presented at the PASC Leadership Conference. We have also presented at the school board meeting and received a school board award. We also have applied for and received a $500 grant from the Bethel Park Community Foundation. Also, something that we are really excited about, Natalie, Macy, and I received the Rotary Student of the Month for September, and we were really excited because we were the first freshmen to ever receive that award.
Why we are doing this? We want every soldier and Marine to know that there are people back home who truly care about them and support their heroic efforts to protect our country. The best way of accomplishing this is by expanding the group, Bring a Smile to the Service, so that we have more people to help spread the love.
Now, we have a few quotes from some servicemen and women that we'd like to share right now. And the first one is from the first soldier that we'd written to, SPC Joshua Clark. And he said, "You are writing to so many soldiers. I know that you're making a difference in their lives just as you did in mine." And this is CPL Jason Yanamira. "Thank you so much for writing and giving us your support. You girls are the best." And then this is also one of the first soldiers that we wrote to, CPL Nathaniel Lopez. "I wanted to thank you for taking the time out of your day to write to me and my Marines. We are very proud to be protecting you and your family."
Where we're going. We're hoping to expand this club as much as possible, and we're going to involve as many individuals as we can.
I've really enjoyed writing to the soldiers and Marines so far, and I hope to recruit more people and to spread the love.
I got started because my social studies teacher, Mrs. Makel, got me into this, and my friend has two brothers that are in the military, and I thought this would be a nice way to help them.
In order to continue to expand the group, we have designed our own flyers, which we have started to disperse throughout Bethel Park and surrounding districts. We have created our own website, which Natalie set up herself, and we have also set up two separate email accounts, one that you can send in letters so we can send them to the soldiers, and the other if you have any questions.
Program growth. We never dreamed that this program would go as far as it has. 3 years ago, it was just some girls and a teacher writing letters at lunch, never comprehending how much those little letters would have on the servicemen and women. After reading their responses and presenting at the PASC conference and the school board meeting, we knew that this was a group far from ordinary. With your help, we are hoping to continue to grow.
Now, these are just some ways that you can keep in touch or, you know, just be in the know in what we're doing. Our website is www.bringasmiletothesservice.webs.com. And, you know, this being the technological era, we have a Twitter. And that's @sendsmiles. Our email is bringasmiletothesservice@gmail.com. And this is an email if you just want to get in contact with us, if you want names of soldiers to write to, or if you just want to ask us questions about what's going on. But if you actually have a letter, now we do this for you to send letters to us so we can read them and send them to the soldier, because we want children to be able to have that buffer so that they're not talking directly to a soldier or a Marine. So you have that, Mrs. Makel reads them as that buffer just to make sure everything is fine and appropriate and able to be sent. And that, to send your letters to, that email is sendasmiletothesservice@gmail.com. So that's about it, and thank you for your time. Any questions?
I think you'll all agree that with this group here and this group standing in the back, we don't have to worry about the future. Thank you so much. Probably some of you will be sitting up here one day. Hopefully.
Shoot higher.
Anybody have any questions for the girls? Any questions? No. You like this program, Mark?
Oh, yeah. It's a very good program. Yeah.
You have already heard of it?
No, it's wonderful.
Yeah, great. Anybody in the audience have a question for the girls? See, you did a perfect job.
Very well done.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
That's all we have tonight, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much, Mayor. I do have one other chair announcement. We had an executive session that was on September 24th. That was personnel and police issues. I missed that under my chair announcements. Okay, at this time, I turn to the approval of the minutes. And Mr. Allen.
I move that we approve the regular council meeting minutes of September 10th, 2012.
Second.
There's a motion and second to approve the regular council meeting minutes of September 10th, 2012. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Allen?
Yes.
Gibbons?
Yes.
Hannon?
Yes.
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Motion passes 7-0. I'd like to turn to approval of the bills and payrolls, and Mr. Allen.
I move that we approve the bills and payrolls for the municipality per bill list number 100812 in the amount of 915,000 $79.94.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. We approve the bills and payrolls for the municipality per bill list number 100812, excuse me, in the amount of $915,079.94. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Gibbons?
Yes.
Hannon?
Yes.
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Allen?
Yes.
Motion passes 7-0. At this time, I'd like to turn to the resident comments section for non-agenda items. If anybody would like to come up to the microphone. Hearing none, can we turn to general policy and finance and Mr. Hannon? And we have no residents signed up to speak.
We have no items on the agenda, but I have one item myself.
Mr. Hannon.
I myself have set up here for about 15 years, and tomorrow is a special day in my family's life. It's my wife and mine, our 30th wedding anniversary. And as far as that goes, we don't do this by ourselves. There's always people behind us. And without the support of our families, we can't do this job as well as do the job that we earn a living at. And I like to wish my wife a happy anniversary for tomorrow. So that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Are there any additional items?
Mr. Murray.
Mr. Harrison.
I'm in my 39th year on council, but I've lived in Bethel Park for about 12 years longer than that. I've been a resident. I'm not a native of this area. We came from southern Indiana, state of Indiana. And so we weren't familiar with the area, and we spent 2 years looking for a place, getting familiar with the municipalities, the areas, and that type of thing. And two things that were significant. Number one, we found a place that we like. In fact, we liked it so well, we still live there. And the second was we checked out school districts, and we were impressed with the Bethel Park School District, because at that time, although that we didn't have children, we planned on having children, which in fact we did. The reason I'm speaking to that is that I, as a long-term citizen, have a real concern when we have a school district that manages to get constructed a Taj Mahal-type high school, which I spoke too many times, I didn't think we need it, but they don't seem to be able to successful in educating our children. Now, why do I say that? Here's an article I have from the Tribune Review Saturday, September the 22nd. It says 17 area school districts fail to meet grade. And the grade they're talking about is an adequate yearly progress. And one of the 17 districts is the Bethel Park District. And I just wanted to make sure people are aware of the fact that our district is one of the 17 that's not meeting the grade. And I'm hopeful that they'll get the message that we, the citizens, expect our children to get a good education. And I, for one, don't think that's working out too well. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Harrison. Are there any additional items? This time, can we turn to planning and zoning and Mr. Allen?
Mr. Mayor, we have no items under planning and zoning this evening.
Okay, do we have any additional items? One note, Mr. Dixon, who's not able to be here with us this evening, wanted me to pass along the residents on Locust and Lawrence Drive area that he had mentioned last month. We submitted a letter to PennDOT. We have not heard anything back as of yet from PennDOT. I know Paul mentioned he wanted to keep everybody apprised of what was going on there, but in his absence, just want to let everybody know. So as soon as we do, we'll let the residents in the area that are affected, Paul will make them aware. Okay, can we turn to health, safety, and welfare, Mr. McLean?
Thank you, Mr. President. First item is the Bethel Park School Guard contract agreement. I move that we approve the contract agreement with the Bethel Park School Guards for a 4-year period with a yearly rate increase of 2%.
Second.
There's a motion and a second that we approve the contract agreement with the Bethel Park School Guards for a 4-year period with a yearly increase of 2%. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Hannon?
Yes.
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Allen?
Yes.
Gibbons?
Yes.
7-0. Motion passes 7-0, Mr. McLean.
Second item is the inordinance, the installation of stop signs at Greenwald Road at Carlton Road. I move that we approve an ordinance to install two stop signs at Greenwald Road at Carlton Road, stopping traffic in an easterly and westerly direction.
Second.
There's a motion and a second that we approve the ordinance to install two stop signs on Greenwald Road at Carlton Road, stopping traffic in an easterly and westerly direction. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Harrison?
I voted reluctant yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
An overwhelming yes.
Allen?
Yes.
Gibbons?
Yes.
Hannah?
Just a yes.
Motion passes 7-0. Mr. McLean.
Those are all the agenda items that we have.
Do we have any additional items?
I have one additional item. Just want to mention that the leaf recycling program begins in 2 weeks. Folks can put their leaves out at the curb on the same day as the regular garbage pickup, provided they're in the approved bags. There's also information available on the website.
If I can also note, the pickup days are going to be October 22nd, 26th, October 29th to November 2nd, November 5th to 9th, November 12th to 16th, November 26th to 30th, and December 3rd to 7th. And there will be no leaf collection on Thanksgiving week. Thank you, Mr. McLean.
Thank you.
Okay, can we turn to Public Works and Maintenance and Mr. O'Brien?
Thank you, Mr. Mowry. There are no items under Public Works and Maintenance, although I have a few.
Mr. O'Brien.
This month is the recognition of the Air Force and the Veterans Memorial. So if all you people that were in the Air Force, get down and get your picture. It's quite remarkable. It's very beautiful. Speaking of veterans, tonight is a very kind of interesting night. One of our family members from this municipality is retiring at the end of the month. And I'm happy to call him friend. Just sitting back and reviewing and talking with Mr. Mowry about all the things that have been done under this man's watch is remarkable. You know, council makes policies, and council sometimes comes up with wonderful ideas, and sometimes people would say harebrained ideas. But whatever we do, it takes our staff to carry them through. And this man has just been stellar. When I first came here, we start working on lighting our neighborhood fields in our parks, and then we worked out an agreement with the school district to light those fields to extend, and Mr. Segrimis was there. And then we started on our neighborhood sewer programs. Mr. Segrimis was there. And then there's a $40 million sewer plant renovation. Also, Bob was there. Community Center, Phase 1, Phase 2, Veterans Memorial, Phase 1, Phase 2, Millennium Park. And through all this, he was here for two blizzards. My grandson was born during one of them. And then he was also here for back-to-back remnants of hurricanes. And those were some days that Mr. Scriminus and I were quite nervous to see if the Logan Creek endeavor actually worked, and it did. And he was here for all that, all those years of trying to solve that. And the people down there are really happy. The Greenwald Project. I'm sure council can come up with more and more. You know what? I couldn't think of the right man in the right place at the right time for Bethel Park. I salute you, Mr. Segrimis, for your remarkable public service, your outstanding service for your country and for our community. Bethel Park thanks you, Bob.
Far be it from me to hold us up from a meeting that might end at 8:15. I remember when the meetings were here till midnight.
I think somebody said there's a 3-minute limit, but I don't want to say who.
We're waiting it tonight.
But I do, Mark, I do appreciate the very kind words. And, you know, I leave here, I've been here almost 18 years, and I leave with a lot of mixed feelings. And, you know, there's satisfaction on those things that have been accomplished, and there's really a lot of sadness with, you know, leaving behind a lot of people, colleagues and friends that have worked with me on all those different projects, and it really is sad to leave those people. I do think that we have a very strong team here at Bethel Park, a strong team with the staff, with council. We get a lot of things done. I certainly appreciate all the support that I've been given, and that's from the top and really, you know, from the bottom. I mean, we've got great people working in this municipality. Our public works department, I think when things are really bad and the weather conditions are really bad, there's nobody better. And, you know, they'll work 18, 24 straight through, making sure that the roads are clear. They do a great job. We've got great people at the sewage treatment plant. And when we get real bad weather conditions, they're working around the clock, making sure that, you know, we meet our permits, that, you know, we keep everything processed properly, and they do a great job. We have, I think, a very strong and capable municipal staff. They know what they're doing. They get a lot of things accomplished, and, you know, I really appreciate all the support I've been given from them. I really am heartened with the selection of Jerry Duke as my replacement. He's been on the staff for a long time. He's a very capable guy, and I think from the standpoint of the municipality, we're in very good hands with Jerry Duke. And I guess the last thing I'll say, and not burn up too much time, but it's time for me to move on. It's cross another mountain and see what's on the other side. And I'm going to miss everybody here, and I wish everybody here the very best.
I hope you didn't initiate a trend. Thank you.
Mr. Spagnuolo.
That's all I have, Mr. Chairman. Yeah.
Okay. Mr. Spagnuolo.
Yeah. Bob, I just would like to say simply that I know you started here in 1995, and honestly, every single day that you've worked here, you've exemplified great leadership, the great work ethic, demonstrated discipline in everything you did, and simply just like to say that job very, very well done. Thank you, Bob.
I just kind of wanted to follow up on Mark, mention a lot of things and events that have happened over the years, and the one thing that everybody out there needs to know, there was a number of people there at all these events, and there's a lot of people that make the community what it is today, but Bob was there for all those events. Whether they were good or bad, he was there. Whether it's the snow, whether it's the rain, whatever it is, he was always there. We may not always agreed on items, and I think, you know, he respected the wishes of council. He was very diligent in sharing his opinion when he thought he needed to, when he was asked, and he's done a great job. And I know attending many of these events and seeing Bob out there, we take all the credit for all the good things that happened, and Bob's the one that really made it happen with his staff, and congratulate Bob on his retirement. I just want to let him know that I think if you retire from Bethel Park, you're not allowed to come to the microphone for, I think it's 4 years. But no, we appreciate everything you've done over the years. Maybe we don't always show it, but I just want to say thank you. I think your help and with everybody, and Jerry's assuming the role, and there's going to be some other changes within our staff a little bit coming up over the next couple months with some personnels. But I think Jerry's had a good teacher, and you've taught him everything, and now he's needs to make it on his own. And I will tell you, Jerry, I said, there are no bad days in Bethel Park. There are just some days that are better than others. Yeah. But anyhow, thank you very much, Bob, and wish you well. And when it's the first snow, we're still going to call you. I got that emergency number on my phone.
Change it's your number.
Bob's home number, I think. But thank you very much for your time and everything you've done and the things we've accomplished as a group. But thank you. Is there any other discussion?
Move we adjourn?
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned, good night, everyone. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, if you want to, if you'd like to come up to the... No, we'll be, we're very accommodating tonight. If you'd like to come up to the microphone, if you wanted to state your name and address for the record, that would be great.
Just because I carry a big stick, don't let me intimidate you.
He doesn't intimidate me.
My name is Ruth Hale. I live at 2530 Highland Circle. I would be in Ward 5, I think, with Mr. Harrison's jurisdiction. I just wrote a letter about requesting a need for sidewalks along Brightwood Road, and I think it's probably been brought up before, but with the recent closing of the Center Street trolley and the Lytle Street trolley stops, there are more pedestrians walking along that to go all the way down to Lytle, and they completely blocked Center Street so you can't even traverse to get over to West Library where there are sidewalks to get to Lytle. And I could read the letter. I don't want to keep you too long, but that's the gist of it.
Okay, if you would like to leave the letter, council will get a copy of it. And we'll see what we can do. We're just actually starting in the budget process also. See, we're sometimes we're nice. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is the meeting to adjourn? Motion adjourned. Good night, everyone.
Do one thing to help prevent 36,000 deaths, help decrease hospitalizations, and the spread of disease, what would it be? Get a flu shot.
Influenza is a serious disease that can lead to hospitalization and sometimes even death.
The flu can affect people differently. Even healthy people can get very sick from the flu, spreading the disease throughout the area.
In 2011, the CDC reported that 20% of the U.S. population contracted the flu, with over 200,000 people being admitted to a hospital for flu-related complications.
By getting a flu vaccine, you can reduce your chances of getting the flu and the possibility of spreading the flu.
When more people get vaccinated against the flu, it decreases the spread of the disease throughout the area, making your community a safer, healthier place to live.
Tri-Community South EMS is offering free flu vaccines to adults in our local communities of Bethel Park, South Park, and Upper St. Clair.
So do one thing this year, get a flu shot. It can save your life as well as others.
For information on flu shots, contact Tri-Community South EMS.
Illegal is illegal, and that's what we have to take care of at the border. Why don't they put blimps up? I think one of the issues is flying airplanes is going to cost money. So I'd throw out, put a blimp up there, run blimps from both sides of the fence line, and they run probably at a...
How can Mr. Bolt have it so wrong? That is one of the worst ideas I have ever heard.
Wait, what's this story? Military surveillance blimps tested at the Texas-Mexico border? Bolt had it right all along. Oh man, never gonna hear the end of this one.
Good morning, this is Mr. Bold calling for Mr. Dave Cable. Back in 2006, Mr. Bold was on Bethel Park right now. And if Mr. Bold recalls correctly, he was poo-pooed by Mr. Dave Cable back in 2006 for really being a wacko when it comes to suggesting blimps along the border. I told you back then that I hoped that I never saw anything official using the word blimp. Well, much to my enjoyment, the word blimp has been used in an official article when they talk about trolling the borders. It's unfortunate that Bethel Park doesn't have any billboards because Mr. Bold would be looking for some type of public apology from Mr. Dave Cable regarding his poo-pooing of the suggestion of using blimps to control the borders. I await your call. Thank you.
I deserve that.
Hi, I'm John Bauer, and I'm here to talk about sudden cardiac arrest. Heart disease, including sudden cardiac arrest, is the nation's number one killer. Sudden cardiac arrest happens when the heart suddenly stops beating. This may be from a heart attack or a number of other causes. Whatever the cause, without immediate action, the sufferer will die. You can take action against sudden cardiac arrest. If you see someone suddenly collapse and it looks like they aren't breathing normally, you need to act immediately. First call 911 or your local emergency number.
Then start immediate chest compressions. Place your hands in the middle of the chest and begin to push forcefully and rapidly, at least 100 times a minute. If anyone else is nearby, have them relieve you after 2 minutes. Keep taking turns. If you're in a public place, ask someone to get an AED. When it arrives, open it up and follow the voice instructions. Don't stop chest compressions until the AED tells you to. Keep going until rescuers arrive. Sudden cardiac arrest is survivable if immediate action is taken. You can make a difference. To learn more or to learn CPR, contact Tri-Community South EMS at 412-831-3710. Be a lifesaver. Learn CPR.